Good evening, everybody. Welcome to tonight's performance. Glad you could make it on this windy Saturday evening. My name is Paul Abeg. This is the Dixie State Symphony Orchestra. It's the orchestra here on campus, and we're glad you could join us. We're excited to share some of the music we've been preparing for the last few weeks for our final concert of this season. We would like to invite you to join us on the first number in commemoration of the freedoms we enjoy here in the United States of America. We'd like you to stand, if you're comfortable, and sing with us the national anthem. Well done. You did so well, we'll let you rest for the rest of the concert. So our next number is also by a very patriotic composer. Most of his music was written with the intent to convey nationalism and patriotism for his land. Antonín Dvořák was from what is now the Czech Republic. Prague was Bohemia when he lived there. But so much of his music conveys the culture and the folk music of his land. And that's the case also with the piece we're going to share with you tonight. This is from his set of Slavonic dances. This is Dvořák's Slavonic Dance number 8. Thank you. So arguably one of the most famous and well-known pieces from the classical repertoire is the next piece we're going to play. Analysts and historians try to figure out what caused the composer to write what they wrote and what was behind it. Rimsky-Korsakov insists that this next piece was not intended to tell a story, but it's based on some paintings that he saw, which were based on the story of 1001 Nights, which is a story common in the Mideast. So the next piece is Scheherazade. It's our signature piece of the evening. If you don't know it by name, I imagine you will recognize the melodies, but we hope you enjoy the next number, Scheherazade by Rimsky-Korsakov. I'm also going to introduce the last number. So at the end of 2020, we lost a dear member of our community, Terry Lamoureux. And Terry was an amazing person and a big supporter of the arts, not only in our community, but our campus, and specifically to this orchestra. He was instrumental in bringing financial support to the orchestra, as well as support in attendance, and we miss him dearly. He had an amazing ability to reach out to people, even people that may not be accessible. One of those people is our guest soloist tonight, who he met online and created a lasting friendship. Mr. Ronke's appearance is in honor of Terry Lamoureux and celebration of his life. And we're grateful that he was able to finally come. We've been working on bringing him here for 3 years, and we're glad he came straight from Italy, and this is the only concert he's performing in the United States, is here in St. George, Utah, and so we're honored to have him for the final number on this evening's concert. So thank you again for being here. We'll perform now Rimsky-Korsakov's Scheherazade.
Thank you. One, two, three. Yeah, okay. So I want to, first of all, thank you all of you for coming here tonight. It's a great pleasure to make music with such a conductor and musician and such a wonderful orchestra. I'm sorry, but my blood is in my hands, so it's, I can't. My bad is English anyway. My English is bad anyway, but I would like to play a Chopin Nocturne, and I want to dedicate it to. I can't describe this person because it's he means a lot to me. Thierry Lamoureux. He brought to me. I met him online on Instagram. So. Sometimes life is strange, and he texted me, Nico, you are wonderful. I want you to come to St. George. I said, let's do it. I'm glad to come. But Jerry is probably the most caring and giving person I ever met in my life. He brought me here in 2017. I performed as a soloist at Eccle Concert Hall. And then I came again in 2018 performing with a violinist, with a French violinist. And but Thierry was not just a random person I met online. We started texting each other every single day. He was my biggest fan, my biggest fan. And when I think about Thierry, I always think how I would like to become when I'll be older. When I think of him, I think of the. I really think I would like to be a husband like he was. I would like to be a friend like he was. I would like to be a father like he was. He's been really an inspiring person. Fortunately, Thierry passed away 1 year or a little bit more than 1 year ago. I remember he loved his family more than any other thing in the world, and we were so close that he wanted me to call him daddy, and actually I was calling him daddy. He was a kind of second father to me, and every day he was telling me how much he loves his wife. He told me many times that the first time he met her. He thought she was an angel. And Marilyn, I don't know where you are, but you really are an angel. He passed away and I really miss him. So I would like, I'm sure that he's looking at me from somewhere. And this summer I'm getting married. And He should have come, but I know he will be next to me, and I really want to dedicate this nocturne to Thierry. Thank you.
Thank you. Dedicate to this piece to the victims of every war in the world. Thank you. last one, which is one of my compositions. I really want to thank you. There's a call for coming up, please. For the orchestra, so I'm very proud to have had the possibility to perform with all of you. I want to thank you also Dixie State University. This is the third time I'm collaborating with Dixie State. I have to say, every time I come here, I fall in love with St. George even more. I perfectly understand why it's getting bigger and bigger year over year over year, because I might retire here one day. I want to thank you, the Dixie State University. I want to thank you also Nancy, the head of the piano department. I had the possibility to work with her wonderful students. It's really great pleasure. And thank you for the St. George community, because I really feel home every time when I drive from Las Vegas to St. George, and I drive through the canyon. I think I'm almost home. I really hope to come back. I already visited Bryce Canyon, Zion National Park, but there is so much to visit and to do here. So I really hope to come back as soon as possible. The last piece I want to dedicate to all of you, since it's almost night, is a lullaby. It's one of my composition, which is included in a CD that you can find in the lobby. So I just want to wish all of you a wonderful night. Thank you again.